a shorter Yin practice today. I know not everyone has that full hour to dedicate to you know, themselves throughout the day, or maybe you're newer to Yin or kind of interested and just kind of want to get a feel for what the practice is like. So throughout this, I am going to use some blocks throughout the practice. If you do happen to have those, feel free to go grab those and have them ready to be handy. So we'll go ahead and get started. And we'll start on our backs, finding a supine butterfly position. We can use these blocks to place underneath the knees, just to help offer a little bit of support here. Just to help start allowing the body to open up. Placing the hands wherever is comfortable to us, whether they're on the belly, down along our sides, and just coming to our breath. Option to move the blocks closer towards the knees to still offer some support while allowing for some more opening. Or if we like, we can remove the blocks completely, knowing we can also at any point add those blocks back in for some support if we'd like. when we feel ready, we can take our hands to the outside of the thighs. Using those hands to gently guide the legs back up, come to find the feet planted onto the mat. We can then allow ourselves to come onto our sides and then slowly pressing ourselves up to come onto our sit bones. So getting ready for caterpillar. So having those legs out long in front of us. We can use blocks here to create a place for the head to rest onto to take the strain away from the neck. So when we're ready, we can inhale and then exhale, folding forward. And certainly if we feel like the back line of our body is tight, we can also bend the knees here to help bring us a little closer down towards our headrest. Just trying to avoid that strain in the neck by providing support. And certainly if you need more blocks or less blocks, you can always adjust as needed. As we reach the halfway point of this posture, maybe we're able to come a little deeper, move a little further to the pose. Maybe we're able to straighten the legs if the knees were bent. Maybe we can lower our head rest. And if not, that's okay too. You can stay right where we are. And you can always come back up if you have chosen to lower and it becomes too much of a sensation, uncomfortable, or even painful. And then slowly, with control, we can begin to walk ourselves back up, pausing for a moment at the top of the spine, nice and long, finding a few breaths before we move on. When we're ready, moving those blocks off to the side. And we'll come to find that front leg just bent out in front of us. So seeing if we can find that nice 90 degree angle, so the thigh coming off the hip, 90 degree bent through the knee, and then the foot at a 90, and then the back leg, we're trying to mirror a similar sort of thing. We can turn ourselves so we're facing over that front leg, and maybe this is where we stay. If you'd like, you can also walk yourself down, coming into fallen deer. Option to use some blocks here to help bring the mat a little bit closer. And certainly if this is uncomfortable, you're always welcome to find yourself in a supine figure four, or even in a seated twist if that's more comfortable for you. And again, as we've been holding here, maybe your body feels ready to allow yourself to come down a little closer to your mat. And if not, that's always okay. You can stay right where you are. We can begin to walk ourselves back up. Again, taking a moment at the top, just sitting with the spine nice and tall, nice and long. We can then come in through center, lifting up the knees, grounding the feet down onto our mat, and then just gently windshield wiping the knees from side to side. And when we feel ready, we can allow those knees to fall towards the opposite side. Finding the opposite leg in front here. Again, trying to find those nice 90 degree angles. And also always the option to come to that supine figure four or a seated twist instead. But when we're ready, if we'd like, we can walk ourselves down. And maybe taking note here of how this side of the body feels compared to the other.
It's always normal for one side to feel a little bit different than the other. So maybe you need something different over here. And just allow yourself to find what it is that your body needs on this side. And as always, the option here to maybe come a little bit deeper. Maybe we walk the arms down. When you're ready, we can walk ourselves back up. Again, taking a moment at the top of that spine, nice and long, finding a few breaths before we allow ourselves to windshield wiper those legs once more. Getting ready for our next posture. We'll start by finding ourselves on hands and knees. So a couple of options to get into this one. Some people like to kind of heel toe their knees out. If it is within your range of motion, you can also kind of move out one leg and then the other. And we're just looking for whatever feels comfortable as far as the distance goes here. And maybe this is where we stay. If you'd like, you can also lower yourself down onto the forearms, maybe onto the belly or onto a block. And as we're here in our frog, we're trying to again keep those nice 90 degrees throughout the legs, the feet, the knee. Flexing the feet to protect the knee. And another option, if this feels like it's just too much, we can always also do a half frog here instead. So having one leg long, and bringing just one up as a bent knee is an option as well. And if you do choose half frog, I'll keep us halfway through so you can switch to the other side. Mm-hmm. And certainly sometimes this is a pose where you might want some extra cushioning underneath the knees. You can always roll up your mat to provide a nice little double thickness there if needed. Or use any sort of pillows, blankets, anything else you might have at home. If we chose half frog, we can take the opportunity to switch up legs now. And if we chose to be in our bullfrog, maybe we take this opportunity as we come to the final stretch, just to gently rock the hips forward and back. A very small movement here. And it might help to release those hips a little bit more. It might feel nice for that inner thigh. And certainly if it feels uncomfortable or this movement is not for you, you can stay right where you are. If we're in half frog, we can take both legs long. If we're in a full frog, we can army crawl, shifting ourselves forward so we come onto the bellies, bringing those knees, the legs together, keeping the feet up towards the ceiling, knees bent, and then just gently allow those legs to fall from side to side here. And then getting ready to come to our final relaxation, whatever that might look like for you. So maybe you're happy here on your belly and you'd like to find your shavasana there. Maybe you'd rather be on your side, your back, maybe even a seated position. If you'd like, we can also come into a restorative fish here for our shavasana. So for that, we'll use one of the blocks, locking it up kind of in between the shoulder blades, and you'll find what feels good for you here, using a second block to rest the forehead onto. So finding whatever height, whatever position feels comfortable for your back, just allowing yourself to come into a nice chest opener here. Also the opportunity to just come flat on your back in a traditional corpse pose. Just finding whatever position allows the body to be comfortable, to allow the mind to settle. We take in our practice, coming back to that breath. we do have any props supporting us, we can gently remove those now. Coming to find a few moments with ourselves, just completely flat on our backs. And then beginning to awaken the bodies, awakening the fingers, the toes, circling the ankles, the wrists. If we are on our backs, we can take those legs together long along the mat, pointing the toes and then sweeping the arms up overhead. We can then allow ourselves to come onto our side, allowing our head to be cradled here, our whole side body supported. And then whenever we're ready in our own time, we can press ourselves up, coming to find ourselves in a comfortable seated position, allowing the eyes to remain gently closed. On our next inhale, we can sweep those arms up overhead, bringing palms to touch. And as we exhale, lowering those hands down to heart center. Thank you so much for allowing me to guide you through your practice. I hope you enjoy the